She states that these make up the survival arc, and where the bell curve is low and long, the more likely for crisis and disaster. But the quicker we can move from denial to decision, or decisive action, the more likely we will retain control and survive the event we're facing. Although her book talks about everything from facing a gunman to surviving an air traffic accident, I believe this survival arc is also relevant to the cybersecurity professional. Denial. It's likely that you've experienced this phase of the arc in your life when faced with a significant event or potential calamity. For example, have you ever been in a place with other people when a fire alarm goes off? What was your reaction and theirs? Did everyone immediately run to the exits? Did you? Probably not. Sat at your desk, chances are you looked up and around at what they were doing. Just like a group of curious meerkats, others would look back at you as if surveying the level of risk around you. And even though you probably had a creeping sense of dread, you ignored it and returned to what you were doing. This isn't something that relates to some unseen calamity like an alarm. During the 9/11 attack, survivors reported that some people on the lower floors of the World Trade Center remained at their desks, finishing calls or emails or chatting calmly to colleagues about what was happening. It was reported that they waited an average of 5 minutes before taking action. It may seem strange to consider, but generally speaking, there was no mass panic when the evacuation did begin. It wasn't like the movies with people running and screaming. Instead, many people calmly marched out of their offices, down the stairwells, taking verbal and non-verbal cues from those around them.